day. VH1, your favorite songs.
Wanna do something?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
I don't know. We got cable TV.
So?
So? They got this really neat new show with this kid who's a major screw-up. And his mom's home all day.
Yeah,
and she
can, right.
Yeah, and she catches him a lot, but she doesn't yell at him. She just makes him tell his dad.
Yeah, and then I bet he yells at him, right?
No, all he says is, Beaver, I hope you learned your lesson.
Wow. You know, my parents could learn something from a show like that.
No kidding.
National title contenders battle as Miami faces California. And Florida State meets Heisman hopeful Tommy Hodson and LSU. College Football Saturday, live on ESPN.
Now we'll join Lonnie Waller on one of his favorite steelhead strains. This particular run is called Dave's Drift. It's a long, deep run with depths of 4 to 8 feet and good current speed throughout. A primary fast current comes in from above, and the secondary current, which is a little slower, comes from the riffle entering to one side. You'll find steelhead where the two currents meet. They hold deep there in the seam before moving upstream. Above, there's a glacial tributary that feeds into this run, cooling the water and sometimes clouding it a little. So, the steelhead will be holding deep. Now that you know the conditions, how would you fish Dave's Drift? I'm going to use my deep water system to get the fly right down near the bottom. A high-speed, high-D shooting taper will reach the bottom in this current, and I might weight the short leader with a couple of twist-ons. I'll use this big number 1/0 Bosch fly with bead chain eyes for added weight. It's a dark pattern that will make a more visible silhouette in the deep water. Actually, there's good water all the way at the top of the run. Just inside that heavy main current, there's a slower secondary current where the fish like to lie. But my favorite spot is right here where that secondary riffle comes in to join the main river. There's a seam there that the fish will rest in all the way down for the next 40 yards or so. It's great resting water for steelhead. Now, I know from past experience just about where the fish will be lying. They'll be resting in that seam directly below me, that spot where the heavy current meets the slower water on the inside, a narrow slot about 4 feet wide. So I'm going to present my fly by casting across, slightly downstream into the heavy water, giving a flip man to straighten the line, because you don't want a belly for this presentation. Now I'm going to feed out the slack, follow with my rod tip until that fly is sunken very deep, and I'm going to pinch it off and follow it as the fly rides right through that seam. Now casting this system is a little tricky because these shooting tapers are heavy, and you'll want to open your loop up a little bit and slow down your casting cycle some. Now let's do it again. I'm going to cast out into that heavy water, make a flip mend to get the line straight. Now I'm going to feed the slack out, which allows the fly to ride right down through that seam. When I think it's deep enough, I pinch it off, follow with my rod tip as it swings right along the bottom, right in front of their noses. Okay, now if I hook one here, it's a good place for me because I can follow downstream. And sometimes on this river, you have to do that. All right, no steelhead. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one step downstream, get over that big rock there. I'll make that same presentation again. Out into that heavy water, give that flip man to get it straight. Feed the slack down, letting the fly sink real deep, pinching it off, and then follow as the fly swings right through that seam. All right, I'll get a little twitch there in the hang down. Tease them if you have to. If I don't get one, I'm gonna go back up to the top and start again because this is really a good run. This has always produced a fish.
There, fish on!
All right, oh, it's a good fish! Woo-hoo-hoo! The old shooting tug of that guy go. Get him on the reel now. All right. Boy, that deep sunken fly went right down the seam, just where we figured he'd be, and he climbed on. Oh, look at that jump! Jeez, he came 4 feet out of the air. There's another one, that's two. All right, oh, what a beautiful fish we got here now. Come on, baby, do it for me. One more time, and there he is, all right. Come on, you got another one in you, I know that. I'm gonna watch my footing here. Boy, he's hammered onto that old boss. Right out on the seam, that fly was just rolling right above bottom. All right, here he goes again, breaking up. He's breaking the river up. All right. Boy, this is a pretty fish, too. Really clean, looks real bright. And I bet she's got the boss right in his lips. Okay, let's see. I'm going to get out a little bit here where I don't lose my balance. This fish is strong. Boy, that deep sunken fly is slow. And you gotta believe in it, but they're there. Oh, what a beauty. What a beauty this guy is. A real jumper, too. He's gonna come again. Oh, come on, come on now. Now he's got this running line back out on me again. I'm gonna have to move down a little bit. Come on, baby. Come on, oh, this is a good fish. Nice fish. Okay, now let me see, where am I here? I'm gonna get around this stuff a little bit. Maybe get out of this fast water and walk them down a little bit so I got a little bit better footing. All right, Dave's Drift, give up this steelhead right now. Come on in, I'm gonna rock it in. Oh, what a good fish. All right, they usually go a little crazy when they get in like this. Maybe they... They're tough when they're in tight like this, boy. You gotta really give them line if you have to. This is where it can really get tricky. You can lose a good fish here. They run between your legs or break off on the rock. So they're tough. See, they've got a lot of stamina. Rocket. All right. Oh, boy, nice girth on this fish. Gonna get down on my knees a little bit here. Maybe I can scoot it in. Oh, what a pretty fish. Come on now. See, without a net, they're a little tricky, but I don't like to use a net. I think this is a lot of fun to get them in your hand and tail them. It takes a little longer, but it's sure a lot more fun. Oh, I got strong leader on here, so we're all right, and I got her hooked right. Come on. Boy. I gotta get back up, I guess. Now we got her going, I think. Come on, baby cakes. Oh, what a beaut. What a beaut. Nope, not yet. Come on now. Get out of there. Back up here. I'm gonna let you go. Get back up here. Come on, one more time. Now, come on now. Oh, boy, look at this steelhead. Look at this steelhead. What a fat beauty. What a beauty. Want to go back up that way, honey? Let me give you a drink. Oh, she's a good 15, maybe 16 pounds. She's really got the girth. Really beautiful. Not a mark on her. Typical example of a prime babeen hand. Bye, baby. Woo-wee!
Hello, I'm John Fabian. I'm proud to have worked with Scientific Anglers to help bring you this television.
Saltwater fly fishing can be.
Billy, 11 o'clock, big wad coming at us.
Got him, Lee.
Is that a mess of fish?
Good Lord,
look at that cow there.
Look at the size of it.
Boy, there's about five fish in there I'd like to have.
Coming right around the belt.
I'm just trying not to spook them too bad.
Right here, Lee.
They didn't turn off. We're in good shape. Might be in good shape here. Boy, that big hog ate. I didn't get him.
Yes, I did, too.
Big fish. Big fish. Big fish.
Oh, he's not doing anything. I don't want to run yet till I can hit him.
That, boys, is a big fish. That is a big moo-moo. Big moo-moo.
What a tank.
Something wrong with him. He's not fighting. He'll probably wake up, but he's not fighting yet. He's 30 feet from me now. Watch him, because he may jump.
Big fish. He may not be 200, but he's big.
Well, I don't know about this fish. I've never had one that is this big who's so docile to start with. I mean, he made three real nice jumps, but he's not wild. He's just going really slow. And the last time he jumped, there was blood coming from his gills. When he hit the water, I can see blood coming back in the water. He may have ruptured some of his gills. If so, it might, you know, it could be a short fight. I hate to say that this early in the game. We're trying to gain some line back now. We've got the net down, the big gaff out. Lip gaff, gloves, belt, rope, foot in his gills, the billy club. So we got all the stuff ready for taking him on board if we can do it quickly.
What's he doing now?
Well, he's just making a little short burst there, being pretty nice. You never know, they can always wake up, you know, they find out they're hooked. This one may not know he's hooked yet.
Look at the size of that thing.
I can't control him too much. I'm moving him back a little bit. But he's acting like a fish you've played for an hour or two. Instead of a brand new freshman, he might have just traveled in from South America last night. Be a little bit tired.
What a tank.
I don't know whether he's what we want. He's got the length. I don't know if he's got the girth or not, but he's sure got the length. Garbaged it. Took it down about 15 inches. See how rough it is? That's the breaks of the game, you know, with these big tarpon out here. Sometimes you're only allowed 1 foot of heavy leader. And if they really, these big fish, they'll come up and just take it right down. And that's what he did. And they can wear through this 15-pound tippet and just about nothing flat. I think maybe that's one reason. He probably had it down in his gills. That's one reason we saw blood fly out. He had it so deep it was in his gills. But you don't hold them very long when they get it down over your tippet like that. That's the way you lose most of your big fish out here, is they take it up about 15, 20 inches. It's hard to believe they can take it that deep, but they sure can.
Unbelievable.
Well, let's go get another one.
All right, we got a school of fish directly ahead of us, 200 or 300 feet. I'm going to circle and see if I can get upwind to them. They chaining again, Billy, or breaking to the right?
I think they're breaking right. Hold it.
The softer swinging around to the right. They're coming right to us, Billy.
On the left.
Eat it. Good.
Better go on all four. He's moving.
Coming around.
He's going to jump again, I think.
Go
jump again.
Pretty good.
That's a wild one. I'm not going to do anything with him to take line now for a minute.
Is that him?
Yeah, stop it.
Double back on us.
Yeah. He's got a big belly in it. Still got him, though. Might see him here in a second. No, he's on this side.
Coming right onto the boat.
Uh-oh. Watch your lead. Watch him. Watch.
Oh! He's behind us. He clear everything?
Yeah.
Coming around.
That is a wow, and he's reversed field four times now. I'm scared of screwing down. He's still really wow. We better go after him, Lee.
Here we go.
He's gone again. Going a little bit deep now, but those jumps hurt him. being pretty docile, but I think he's still got a jump left in him. Ready, Lee?
Just a second. Ready? Quick time on this fish.
Oh, we've had him about 10 minutes. You see how thick he is? You see that depth? That means he's got weight.
Twice.
You get straightened out?
Yeah. It's straightening right out, Billy.
Get you out of gear. Bigger than I first thought, Billy. when he first jumped.
Slide him in here this time.
Okay.
Got the new gaff. Got him.
Big devil.
Had him over.
Get that hook. What's that point? Okay, he looks like about 130, doesn't he, Lee?
Yeah.
Real deep and real wide. All right, we'll revive him. I'll electric along a little bit and we'll try to revive him here.
He's in pretty good shape right now, Billy. Yeah, it's a big fish, bro.
He's a good fish, boy. In another year, he'll be a monster.
Okay.
I think he's going to survive all right.
He's ready right now, Billy. If I can get this gap out.
Okay.
Okay.
You got him?
Yeah.
He's okay.
There he goes.
Nothing wrong with him. In
well,
good shape.
Quick time, Billy. Quick time.
10 minutes?
Skills. Educate younger hunters with the attitudes and skills essential to a true outdoor sportsman. Support conservation efforts which can assure good hunting for future generations of America.
United Airlines, from the ground up, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies.
Welcome to Fly Fishing Mastery from 3M Scientific Anglers, the world's largest manufacturer of high-performance fly lines. There's nothing like the challenge of fly fishing. It's a sport you can enjoy your entire life. In this series, you'll learn from some of the world's most knowledgeable anglers as they go after fly fishing excitement. Whether you like to fish for trout or bass, or go after bigger game like steelhead, or even giant tarpon, you'll not only learn how to do it, you'll also understand why you do it, as the experts from Scientific Anglers show you the formula for success that has made them and will make you a master fly fisherman. In this program, you'll experience some of fly fishing's most exciting moments. You'll see Billy Pate fight and land the fourth largest tarpon ever taken on fly tackle. Then, Gary Borger will fish dry flies in fast water for big trout. But first, you'll see that steelhead will come to the surface to take a fly as Lonnie Waller fishes the Babine River in British Columbia. Stay with us. We'll be right back. The Ultra 2 fly line is the farthest shooting, highest floating, easiest to pick up and recast, right where you want it. For maximum control in your fly fishing, pick up an Ultra 2. It's available at better fly shops and sporting good dealers everywhere. The ultimate fly line, Ultra 2.
When NASCAR driver Davey Allison readies his boat for a day of fishing, he includes new Havoline outboard two-cycle engine oil. Because Havoline two-cycle meets TCW2 specifications, it prevents cylinder scuffing, exhaust port clogging, and plug fouling. And it promotes a cleaner engine for easier starts. New Havoline outboard two-cycle engine oil. It's a winner you can depend on. Ask for Havoline outboard engine oil by name.
The first time we fished here, years ago, a Canadian honker adopted us for the day. It was good water then. Let's see what it can do now. Goose is the bottom end of a long run. The water above is deep, and below there's a long section of rough, heavy water. This whole tail out is good resting water with rocks and depressions throughout. The fish will lie almost anywhere from the lower portion of the run down to the lip of the riffle below. The best water starts here, and you have 50 yards of good water to fish. As you can see, it's a smooth, even flow, and it's shallow, only 3 to 5 feet deep. The water temperature is up a little, right at 50 degrees. Okay, how shall we fish goose? I think this is an ideal opportunity to try for a steelhead on the surface. I'll add an 8-pound test tippet because I'll be using a Waller Waker, which is tied on a light wire hook. Even though it's tied with materials to keep it on the surface, I still dress the fly before using it. Now you fish the waking fly almost like a downstream wet fly, only the fly is on the surface so you can see everything. Now the key is to let the fly wake and make a V as it moves across the stream and downstream from you. So sometimes you have to lead a little bit with your rod tip to keep that tension. Sometimes you may have to drop your rod if the current's a little faster. Remember, the key is to keep a steady pressure on the fly because that's what makes it wake and that's what stirs up the steelhead. Now let me show you that one more time. We'll make our cast out and slightly downstream. Let the fly land on the water. Put a little bit of belly in your line there. That sometimes is a good thing to wait to speed the fly up a little bit. Now you follow with your rod. So kind of what you're doing here is you're using your rod and your belly and the line to make that fly wake as she moves across stream. That steady V is what you're looking for. Now, if you don't get a strike, you can pick your fly up, make that same drift again, or you can take a step downstream and make a new cast. Remember, each time you step down and you're fishing a new cast, it's a whole new ball game and you may have a fresh fish just waiting to climb on that fly. So now I'm going to follow with my rod tip, lead a little bit. That keeps that fly moving. Remember, the key is to keep the right amount of tension on the fly to make it wake. And there's a big fish just boiled, and we may have a chance to get that guy up. All right, there he rolled again. Let's see, I'm going to lengthen my line a little bit here. That fish is a little bit further out, but let's see if I can reach him here now. Sometimes they show themselves like that. You can actually hook them. All right, now the fly's waking, it's coming across. I'm gonna ease off, give it a little slack to keep it from going too fast. All right, it's coming around. All right, no steelhead. So I'm gonna take a step downstream now, get a little bit closer to him. Let's give it to him one more time. You can coax them up. Remember, they're not here feeding on insects. What we're trying to do is to coax that fish into taking our fly. So we give it several presentations. Now I'm gonna make that fly. Now it's V. There it's waking. Coming across, swinging just right. Now I'm gonna pull, give it a little twitch there. Okay, no grab. Well, now I'm gonna follow it around, let it get out of that fish's zone. Now I'm gonna pick it up. I'm gonna strip out just a little bit of line and give it to him one more time. That same cast, quartering downstream, keep the tension on the fly, let it make that V, and just follow in as it swings around. Now it's waking just right. I got the tension on the fly. It's coming around. Oh, he boiled on it. He didn't take it, though. He didn't take it. He just came up and rolled. Oh, hee-hee. Let's give it one more shot. Same cast. Out and down. Get the fly starting to swing by pulling back my rod a little bit here. Now it's V-ing. Now I'm going to slack off a little bit. Keep that tension at the right rate of speed. He's coming around. Boy, he took it. All right, right on the water waker. All right, let's see what he's gonna do. What a grab. Right, come up just like a trout and hit that thing. Gulped it right in. I think he's got it right in his lips. Okay, well, let's see what he's gonna do. I got a good bottom here. And, oh, there's a beautiful jump. Look at that guy come out, a chromer. Okay, now we got the drag. Well, check your drag. Keep your drag set tight. Not too much pressure. I got a light dry fly tippet on here now, so you can't hog a fish on a dry fly tippet like you can on a heavy wet fly. Maybe we get another jump out of this guy. Go, look at him bucking. He's heading down. Come on, baby, come on. I better get a little bit better footing here. Wait and see what he's going to do. He's going to move down. I'm going to follow him a little bit. Stack that line on the reel in case he runs again. You don't want a backlash. And you can't do much with your fish by rocking your rod when he's this far away from you. So I'm just going to keep steady, constant pressure on him. You see if I can turn him and talk him into coming back up here. I got a good bottom, a long way to fight the fish. I got the rod locked underneath my forearm. Oh, look at that guy tear up the top. Look at that. That's two beautiful jumps. Watch where you're walking. Check that drag. There he goes. All right. Now I'm going to get a little bit of that back. You can tell. Uh-oh, now he's running right at me. I'm going to strip in the line because I can't keep up with him on the reel. Now he's going to jump. He's coming up, coming up, coming up. All right. Keep him on the reel. Strip when they run at you like that, and then let him have it back again. You got to handle your slack with your other hand, and don't let it get wrapped around the reel handle. But oh, there's a beautiful jump. Look at that guy right in the tail out. Now, that fish saw that fly three times before he took it. Most of the time, if they feel the hook, they won't come back. But this guy just rolled on it, didn't feel it, and we gave it to him again, and he took it. Now, he's kind of taking it easy on me now. What's he doing? Okay, there he goes. Now, oh, look at that fish. That fish is 15 pounds if he's 3 ounces. This guy is, I think, is 15. He may be a little bit more. It depends on his girth. He looks like he's got the length for 15 pounds. And if he's got the girth, we got a great catch on a dry fly. I'll tell you, that's about as good as it'll get. He's still fresh, though. He's going to go. I don't have him yet. Keep your rod down low. Sweep him from side to side. Keep him off balance. Oh, there he goes. There he goes. Oh, look at that. You never know how well they're hooked. Oh, man. And you never know if he's chafing your leader. The current's kind of fast here. I'm going to try and walk him. There, we got him walking now. Come on, baby. Come on, tighten that drag up a little bit. I'm ready to give line if I have to. You pump him in, and then reel as you lower your rod back to the fish. Just walk him right into you. I don't know, can't see it yet. Okay, babe, now let's see what we got. Oh, boy, look at that steelhead. Let's see what we got. We don't have it yet. I'm going to try and swing it around above me. Oh, yes, sir. That's 15. Easy. Nope, not between my legs. You don't. All right, now there's a fish on a dry fly. Right there. Look at that guy. Looks like, well, I don't know. Might be a girl fish. Can't tell. I don't know. Or I'll give her a drink, or him a drink, as the case may be. I got the barb down. Should slide right out. Let me look at you one more time. I think, the prettiest thing I've seen all day today. Boy, and right on the surface. Boil for the fly, and then you took it, didn't you? All right, sweetheart, I'm going to try and just take this right out of you. Should just fall right out of there, just like that. Now, how about a nice, pretty release? Nothing too violent, because everything's fine. You're going to go back in, give you a drink. Okay, kid, there you go. Head you right into the river. Get a big drink. Move you back and forth a little bit. There you go. All right. She's ready. Woo!
We do have a problem.
We do?
Ah. Say, you're the CEO in that leveraged buyout, aren't you?
I sure am.
Yes, I've been following that on cable TV. Well, sure, the government encourages buyouts, but we taxpayers carry the burden.
Yeah.
And corporate bonds have dropped 50%.
How are you?
Me? Why, I'm a corporate bond holder. There, we feel so much better.
It's time once again for a new season of Cable Bingo. Join Bob Hyatt and Lori Dale as they call 60 numbers and you play along at home. Pick up your free cable bingo cards at Robert Street Auto Parts in West St. Paul, Furniture Barns in South St. Paul, and on Rice Street in St. Paul. Guardian Furniture and Carpet on University Avenue, and the Cherokee Sirloin Room in West St. Paul. Join in the fun and win cash and valuable prizes on Cable Bingo. That's every Wednesday at 7:30 on City Vision Channel 10.
Alain Prost is on his way to winning his third World Driving Championship, but four races remain. The excitement continues at the Grand Prix of Portugal, Sunday at midnight Eastern on ESPN.
Now here's Billy Pate with a classic saltwater battle.
Billy, 9 o'clock behind you. Big fish coming in.
Okay.
9 o'clock, about 100 feet, coming right at us.
Got it.
Yeah, Mike.
If I can just hit him.
That's the fish we're looking for, Billy.
God almighty. It's
the fish we're looking for. God, it's a huge fish.
That's the monster, boys.
God, this is the one, Billy.
What a monster. Look at the other monsters down there.
Oh, let's take him, Billy.
Almighty.
I'm shaking all over. Holy mackerel. Oh, my God.
Yeah, he didn't throw me, did he?
My heart's going 9 million miles in a minute. Jesus, God almighty. You got him?
Yep, I got him.
We got a real big fish on here. It's my fish. 10 years I've been looking for this fish.
Well, he's still at school. I'm trying to break him out, but I'm being pretty easy with him because there's a whole herd of fish down there.
He's still at school, isn't he?
Yeah. There's the herd. I'm just afraid to tighten it up too tight when he's still in that school. Well, he stayed with the school for about 3 miles. We finally had to put the big engine down and chase him. I got up close to him, got him on the fly line. I broke him out of the school with some low blows. So then we pulled the big engine back up again so we wouldn't mess it up for all these other guys. And we've got the electrics down now, and we're working him on the electrics. But when he wants to go, he just goes. I don't near have him under control yet. I'm just trying to tie him down a little bit. But I'm a long way from having him under control.
Double back on you, Billy.
Yeah.
Don't scare me like that.
He's trying to keep me off just like I'm keeping him off.
Coming across. This is an erratic fish, Billy.
Yeah, he is.
Goes right, goes left.
Won't let us get closer than 30 feet on the fly line. I can't gain much on those rolls. He's learned to keep moving. He's not too tired. Comes up in rolls and just a momentary pause, but I can't back him yet. Still got a lot of power. Whenever he wants to go, he just goes, and you can't horse him. You can't horse him at all. You can work on him. See, he's running now. All I can do is just stand here and let him go. And he's going. Nothing I can do to stop him. Can't even work on him when he's doing that. I'm just wasting energy if I'm pumping when he's running like that. And when he makes a turn or he slows down, I go back to work on him. He really put on a burst of speed there. Well, I've got about 5-6 pounds on now. I just checked it when I had a little moment when he wasn't pulling tight against it. And 5-6 pounds, that's all I want to risk on the reel. I've been putting a couple of pounds on with my fingers, but about an hour and a half now, my hands are starting to get a little tired, and so I'm going to start letting the reel do most of the work now. Take my hands off the line and try not to make a mistake. Is that a big fish? That's big. Big moo moo. Look at that fat, would you? Big moo moo. Got the line around his tail. He's flapping it about that wide.
We've been facing the, chasing this fish 2 hours.
Let's get on him, Lee.
And we've chased him about 7 miles, 7 to 8 miles.
Got the first good look at him just now. We had him, what, 2 hours or something? He looks really long, looks 7 feet long. That's about the biggest back I think I ever had in front of me.
Don't let you row, you bastard.
We had this fish on about 8 hours and 15 minutes. We've gone over 25 to 30 miles tracking the fish, and we're getting pretty close now.
Well, we've had him on his side once, and I back him up occasionally, but he still flaps his old big tail and goes.
We just can't get quite close enough to the fish.
Midnight that night, an exhausted Billy Pate would relate the story of a 9 1/2 hour battle that ended just after dark. He would tell how Lee sunk the gaff into the huge tarpon and the fish pulled the guide right out of the boat. But Lee hung onto the gaff and with help from another boat, finally landed the fish. Then there was a long run home in the dark. This is the fourth largest tarpon ever taken on a fly rod. It weighed 184 3/4 pounds. Just 4 pounds short of Billy's 188-pound record. Now, what kind of an effort do you think it'll take to land a 200-pound tarpon with a fly rod?
Hello, I'm John Fabian. I'm proud to have worked with Scientific Anglers to help bring you this television series. But wouldn't it be great to have your own library of fly fishing videos that you could watch anytime, right in your own home? Well, now you can. Grab a pencil and paper, and I'll tell you how you can start your own fly fishing video library with this special offer from Scientific Anglers.
If you want to learn the complete formula for success for fly fishing, then you want to own Formula for Success Trout, chosen as a Field & Stream video library selection. Three top fly fishing experts will show you the way to consistently catch more and bigger trout on a fly. If you're just starting out, Fly Fishing Made Easy will teach you everything you need to know to begin fly fishing for trout, bass, or panfish. Right now, if you order both Formula for Success Trout and Fly Fishing Made Easy at just $19.95 each, 3M will give you absolutely free this Scientific Angler's Fly Box. So call now 1-800-779-FISH for your copies of Formula for Success Trout and Fly Fishing Made Easy at just $19.95 each. Call 1-800-779-FISH. Charge it on your credit card. If you order both, you'll receive a Scientific Angler's Fly Box absolutely free. Call 1-800-779-FISH.
I used pressure-treated lumber, and I still have $800 in water damage. How come?
Even treated wood needs Thompson's Water Seal protection.
Patio was supposed to last for years. Now I have $1,200 in damage. Why?
Your concrete wasn't protected with Thompson's Water Seal. Thompson's penetrates into wood, brick, or concrete to form a barrier water can't get past even when driven by 98 mile per hour winds.
Let it rain. This time I use Thompson's, a great defense against repair expense.
Thompson's, the first name in lasting protection.
Next, Gary Borger will show you how to fish pocket water for trout.
A rapids is a place where the bottom of the river is inclined more steeply than it is in a riffle, and the currents are much faster. Like many rapids, this one has a lot of boulders in it. Behind these boulders are small pool-like areas called pockets. Although it's tough wading in places like this, I like to fish pockets because, like pools, they hold big trout. Don't just cast your fly anywhere in rapids. Fish rarely come up through heavy currents like that to take a dry fly off the surface. Concentrate your efforts where they'll do the most good. That means fishing the pockets. Now, pockets contain the same types of lies that pools do. Back in the tail of the pocket, there are feeding lies. You can see the current spinning out into the tail of the pocket, so any food organisms floating down in the current would spin out there into the tail to the waiting fish. There's also a feeding lie right in front of the boulder where there's a hydraulic cushion, and fish will hold there oftentimes and feed. And that's always worth the cast or two. And then don't forget the concepts of the feeding lane and concentration of currents. Wherever you have a concentration of currents like this, you have a concentration of food items, and you'll have fish moving in there to feed. So places like this would be very good places to fish with a dry fly. Now there's a prime lie in a pocket right at the head here where the fish can hold right at the edge of the fast current down on the bottom by the boulder. But because that water's so deep and fast, the fish usually won't come up for a dry fly. That's a better place to fish a nymph. I'd concentrate my efforts along this line and back there in the tail of this pocket. And oh, don't forget to fish the pockets near shore, especially if there are bushes nearby. Grasshoppers might jump out of the grass into there, or bugs fall off the bushes, or fish them when there's a big hatch on, because trout will slide out of this deep water into those shallow pockets to feed. The usual way to fish this type of water is to cast upstream, working from pocket to pocket. Because there are so many current tongues of varying speeds, drag is the most important problem you have to overcome. So don't stand a long way off and cast into the pocket. 50-foot casts are totally unreasonable in this kind of water. Keep your cast short, 20 to 30 feet are maximum lengths. Don't worry about the fish seeing or hearing you, because the surface is choppy and there's a lot of background noise. There was a rise right in front of me there. That fish was only 6-7 feet away. But wading close won't overcome all your presentation problems. You've got to be able to introduce some slack into the line. Here's a couple of casts that'll help you do that. Now, you know in a normal cast that you have a high back cast and a low forward cast. In the puddle cast, you're going to use a low back cast and a high forward cast. Cast the line forward, then drop the rod tip right down, and the line will puddle up on the water, throwing a lot of S-curves that will eliminate drag. There are pockets, such as this one, that just can't be reached by wading upstream. So you've got to fish across stream. And drag is really a problem here. Because that's such a difficult spot to get to, not many anglers will try it. Let me show you some techniques that allow you to get into difficult spots like that. I'm going to use a reach mend to introduce slack, and then I'm going to mend the line on the water to get a nice drag-free float. Make a reach like that, and then as the line comes tight in the current, just keep mending it back upstream. Just lift the rod tip and flip that extra slack back upstream. Keep flopping it up there. Then reach your arm out as far as you can to get a nice long drag-free float. Pick the fly up. Reach it way upstream, and as the line starts to come tight, pick that slack up with the tip of the rod and just flop it back up there. Now, if you're fishing to a fish that's in that feeding lie right above the boulder, you can reach it with a reach mend or a single curve mend. Here's what the reach mend looks like. Cast up and reach it off to the side. The fly comes right down in front of the rock, and the line goes right around, just like that. Cast up and reach it right around. Here's the single curve. Cast up, curve the line right around the rock. Cast up, curve the line right around the rock. The fly comes straight down in front of that rock, right into that feeding lie. Got it. Oh, it's a nice rainbow. Look at him jump. Woo! Look at him go. Hot fish. Boy, that fish in that pocket water is exciting. Boy, those fish really take that fly. Bang, they got it, and then down they go. Remember to follow fish like this in this fast water, because they'll pull off if you don't. Boy, that was a good run. And get in that fast water. Get your rod over to the side like this. Pressure them a little bit, get them into these quiet pockets along shore. Boy. Tough landing them in this kind of water, because
tough wading, tough moving. Come on there, fish. Boy, they really use that current to their advantage. Can't get him into this pocket of quiet water here. There he comes. And that's why I like to fish pockets.
Rate of 120. He's looking good.
The Emergency Medical Services. Aren't you glad they're there? A public service message from Quantum Chemical Corporation.
Rick Mears is in hot pursuit of points leader Emerson Fittipaldi. He could steal the lead with a win at the Bosch Spark Plug Grand Prix. Sunday night at 9:30 Eastern on ESPN. Which team will be known as the Beast of the East? This key battle could decide. Pittsburgh clashes with Syracuse on College Football Saturday. Tonight at 7 Eastern, live on ESPN.
Fly fishing, it's a world of fun, learning, and excitement. At 3M Scientific Anglers, we're here to help you remove the mystery while keeping the magic of fly fishing. All the scenes in this program were selected from our Mastery Learning System video library. If you practice the techniques you've seen today, we guarantee you'll become a better angler.